Don't bite my finger. They need to eat 24/7, 365. I like observing them and watching the cycles they live through. Good dog. My name is Susan Goren, and I think I'm destined to be known as the Squirrel Lady of Washington Square. I was a kid in Washington Square. Back in the 80s, I used to watch all the street performers, and it was one of the most alive, exciting places in New York. I'm one of those people that has carried a camera with them always. Just whip mine out and start filming. Okay, these photographs are of a fellow named Tony Vera. Tony Vera is known in the street performing world as the fireman. He is a fire blower and a stunt guy. He's actually lifting children in a chair and balancing on his chin, and he actually does a complete turn without hands. And I was very thin in those days. And I said to him one day, you know, Tony, I don't think those kids weigh much less than I do. And his eyes lit up, and it was like, yeah, you brave enough, Susan? And there I am. I would sit up there and I could see above all of the crowds in the whole park. Then there was Philippe Petit, the man that walked the tightrope between the trade towers. These pictures in my left hand were taken, and I like them because it shows him on a low wire, even though he does the high wire in much more spectacular places. When Washington Square Park was under threat of the renovation that's ongoing, Philippe and I were in touch by email, and he actually came down two or three times in the summers and did his performance and helped us raise a little money towards the lawsuit. When I was roughly 11 or 12, I remember going to the park. There was music, there was activity. All different kinds of people that made it the kind of place where someone's grandmother from Queens would come for the price of a subway token and say, where can I get this kind of entertainment for that money anywhere else? Unfortunately, the city politics with Mr. Bloomberg thinks that the way the park itself looked was not suitable. And what they've done is they've eliminated that space by flattening the entire center. And what will happen now that they've moved the fountain 23 feet east is that all the students will sit as an auditorium audience for the graduation. It's the center of the park, and the university sees it as the center of their campus. And I have said many times at public meetings, this is our neighborhood, and the university exists within it. It is not a campus, it is our neighborhood. And the park was once magical. Because the construction workers didn't understand the contents of the rat poison in Washington Square, 27 mature squirrels died over the summer.
Just a little baby crawling on my fingers.
See that? It's very tiny squirrel. My mom always said everyone loves a baby, and I always say it doesn't have to be a human baby. These little critters are kind of like my pets, and I've come to really love them because they're very engaging and very cute, and the more I watch them, the more fascinated I became. And now that I'm on disability, I've been observing them. And I met someone I knew who actually is a rehabber of animals in New York. I suddenly became the person that would take the injured animal in a carrier up to the vet if none of the other rehabbers could help. And now I am a magnet for harmed squirrels because I've had three of them in the last 10 days. And only one survived, but it was a nursing female, and we put it back in the park last week. This one. Okay. If you go out early in the morning, you might find a squirrel on the corner of the Gray Gallery, or see a squirrel running up University Place to the news. They literally range in this neighborhood. But here we are, the park is half closed. there was clearly going to be a movement to shut it down because it was about real estate interests that little people can't fight anymore. And this really is their turf. When people say, don't feed that animal, I don't want that animal near me. Oh, and they get up with their food. I think, but you're sitting in their living room. This is their home. We're the visitors here.
And I'm also sort of the historian, because now people come in droves, people that have never been, and they want to know what happened to the performance space in the center.
Okay.
When I want to see anyone.
I'm someone that can explain what it was like.
It leaves me a little bit sad that things were one way and are now so radically different.